This year, Project Niño 208 was another great success. We're most fortunate in having a wonderful and experienced team of pediatric doctors with not only a deep and broad knowledge of the field of medicine, but most importantly, who have an extraordinary human touch for dealing with children. I want to stress this, who have an extraordinary human touch for dealing with children. This outstanding team of doctors includes Robert Kazarian, Eleanor Sorn, Ken Dunn, Maurice Gillespie, Mark Barrett, Gracie Esquivel, Carmen de la Rosa, David Brazil, and Melissa Aguirre. These people very generously choose to participate year after year with marvelous outcomes, with marvelous outcomes. In addition to our two American dentists, Dr. Emilio Garcia and Dr. Emilio Ronald Sani, we had a team of 12 Mexican graduate students from the University of Iztacala in Mexico looking after hundreds of children that needed dental care. Our very dear Dr. Terry Hutchinson put forward his vast experience and knowledge in neurology. He was also responsible for giving out 27 wheelchairs to children with significant handicaps. Although our main goal is the care of children, there is no way we can turn down seeing some adults. Dr. Johnson has volunteered to look after these patients. Needless to say, he does a wonderful job. A key part of Project Niño is the operation of a drugstore, which provides free medicines as prescribed by our team of doctors. This entails a huge effort to have an abundant and broad supply of medicines. Chuck Olver, assisted by Stephanie Cooper, are responsible for overseeing and managing our supply network. This year, we were very fortunate to have a local professional optometrist and two attendants to check on the needs of glasses. We gave out 100 new reading glasses and 200 reconstructed lenses. Unfortunately, Dr. Bill Jones and his team were unable to join us this year due to family complications. Some special cases require medical attention and support beyond that which can be provided at our temporary clinic. In such cases, we send the patient to a specialized clinic or hospital for treatment. All of this calls for special arrangements and follow-up, as well as transportation and cash for bare essentials, analysis, operations, medicine, etc. This year, we were also lucky to have a team of specialized technicians and teachers who taught the parents of other children how to cook, utilizing energy and heat from the sun instead of wood or other fossil fuels. Those who attended the lectures were so enthused that they went ahead and purchased a portable solar cooker, which we provided at a cost of only $2. Additionally, people were shown how to build a very inexpensive oven for multiple uses. Along these same lines, we have recently implemented a lecture and talks program to take advantage of the time the parents and children spend waiting in process. Among the various topics covered, we can mention preventive personal care, a balanced diet, cheaper ways of preparing nutritious meals, protecting the local environment, etc. It is important to keep track of various statistics so that we can measure both impact and effectiveness. Following are a series of facts and records that reflect what was accomplished during this 1 week of intensive activity at Project Niño. Number of children that were looked after, 2,622. The number of adults, 1,081. Glasses given out after seeing our optometrist, 298. Patients sent to a clinic where they receive a set of glasses or glasses with special prescription, 80. Patients sent to specialized hospitals in the neighborhood, 136. Number of talks or conferences on various topics, 73. Total attendance at these talks, 1,383. The number of prescriptions that filled out at our drugstore, 2,679. Number of wheelchairs donated, 27. Number of lab tests carried out, 100. Number of patients who receive orthopedic prostheses, 2. It is also important to mention that in order to make Project Niño work, more than 70 people dedicate a lot of their time to administrative and safety matters, discipline, cleanliness, order, promotion of the event, acting as translators, preparing meals for our doctors and staff, and simply making sure that everyone is taken care of. A special mention should be made of the school's headmaster, Mrs. Maria Luisa Oidor and her staff, who put their vacation time as well as the school at our complete disposal. Project Niño, always led very enthusiastically by Dr. David Hodge, is a venture whose reach and success cannot be gauged or measured simply through statistics. Evidently, the number of children whose medical needs were addressed and taken care of is the core of our program. However, the reach and impact of our program extends well beyond that. The general well-being of the communities where we have centered our efforts during the 23 years that our program has been in place has improved dramatically. While poverty is still a challenge, the health problems that the children now exhibit are those more typical of middle-class children rather than the ones that we confronted in the early years, which were in great measure due or compounded by poor hygiene and years without treatment. The parents of many of the children today attended this program in its early years, and their general health is significantly better than that of their parents when they were part of the program. Most of the more dramatic cases now come from communities that are farther away and where we are now starting to have a similar impact. Hence, the impact of our program is now not only temporary, but has gradually and permanently transformed the lives of all the members of those communities. Furthermore, the fact that a group of very generous American doctors and their sponsors took the initiative to dedicate a week of their very busy lives at the expense of their medical practice and family time helping children in a foreign land has not only strengthened the perception and friendship that Mexican people feel for their American neighbors, but has planted a seed that has borne fruit. Today, the majority of the people involved in the program and Mexican volunteers who have helped not only expand the extent of the program, but are involved in the follow-up and financing of the most severe cases throughout the year. It is also usually the case that when a program has been in place for a long time, it starts losing its energy and inspiration. Project Niño seems to be an exception to that rule. Every year, the number of American pediatric doctors that are willing to come down continue to rise. And this fact, together with implementation of new ideas and continuous improvement, have made the program ever more effective. This gives us a feeling that Project Niño is here to stay, in spite of and thanks to extraordinary 23-year history.